Hello everyone, I'm Alex and welcome back to another video. I'm here with George Clarkey. Wow. Already?
Gotta get the plug in quick.
You gotta actually be like funny first.
Oh, okay.
And as we know, based on KSI reacting to you.
Oh, there, yeah, that's not good.
You're not.
Not good track record.
No.
YouTube is certified to be funny.
I guess you're supporting the cause.
Well, we're trying to do a try not to laugh today, to be honest. That is basically the plan. You're already breaking and then you just pretended to not do.
No, try not to laugh at Paul.
Snapshot eye. Paul.
I could never laugh at Paul.
I actually, genuinely, and I don't care what people say, I actually love him.
No, surely you don't.
No, man, I actually fully respect and rate him. I think he is amazing.
What could you possibly rate about this man?
We're friends on TikTok. You know when it says your friend? Every time Snapchat
I
post,
I follow that much.
Every time it goes your friend, and I don't know. They need to change that. I think they need to change that tagline.
Change that label.
We're going to just see really what videos are up there, because I was going to go through and we were going to watch his TikTok, but every single one has been basically taken down, or he's
no
deleted
comments.
Them.
You can't see the comments on them. That's the best bit.
You need to go on re-uploads of Paul's videos to see what people are saying. So let's just start with this one.
You're saying I'll meet 20-year-olds to go geocaching because it's crazy. It's really exciting. You tell me off for meeting 20-year-olds. What happens if I was a 42-year-old gay man and a bunch of 20-year-old men asked me to go to the football?
What a hypothetical situation that is. How are you going to tee off with that?
You know when you've got that weird bloke who's, you know, you're at an afters and it's kind of died down a bit, and somebody goes, I've got a game for you. You've never met him in your life. That's Paul.
I understand. What answer is he expecting from this?
Is he
proving a point there?
I've got a hypothetical for you. Right. Let's say you're a 42-year-old gay man and a bunch of 20-year-old lads ask you to go to the football. What are you doing in that situation? You going, oh no, there's like a 22-year-old,
I don't understand.
22-year age gap.
Why does me being gay mean it's the football?
Well, I think what he's saying is, right, is that
I'm not just going to shag him at the football. What do you mean?
I think that's his point. His point is,
am I backing up Paul right now?
He may be a 42-year-old man. He wants to go geocaching.
There's no doubt he is a 42-year-old man.
He is a 42-year-old man. He may want to go geocaching with a bunch of 20-year-old girls. But that's not CD. The difference is with the football is you're in a stadium, 80,000 people. Geocaching.
Yeah.
The whole point of geocaching is you take people into forests and try and find hidden things.
Well, I've been on my own.
Have you actually been geocaching?
I'm not on my own. I thought it'd be funny for a video. It wasn't really.
You might run into him.
No, that would have put me off.
You and him have more in common than I think. Also, can I just point out, look at this, by the way. Look at what he does.
Exciting. You tell me off for meeting 20-year-olds. What happens?
Oh, why have you pulled that up?
Why has he done that?
Why are you going to zoom and enhance on that bit? I don't want to.
Why did he say 20-year-olds? And he went, what is that about? Like, what's he doing there? I don't know.
What's his job?
He's
currently in a house, unless he's sort of doing like a bathroom tour of the UK. How is he getting into a bathroom?
We'll get into that. This is his dad's place. He lives with his dad.
No judgments.
No, he's 40 fucking two though. And he does have a kid.
He's got a kid?
Oh, do you not know about this? So Snapshot I had a kid with, like, I think it was like some 17-year-old when he was like 26 or something.
Allegedly.
Yeah,
because he made it start. This is all I love how romantic the notebook.
Paul's living my dream, man.
What?
No, I'm joking.
I was a 42-year-old gay man. And a bunch of 20-year-old men asked me to go to the football. Would that be acceptable? I'm waiting for the yeah, because it's the football, mate. Yeah.
For a hypothetical gay man, he plays a heterosexual male very well.
He does, actually.
That was really good.
I'm quite sold, man.
It's the football, mate.
That's how all straight men at the football are, to be fair.
I felt like I was Old Trafford then.
Yes, yeah. And he goes there a lot, as you can see. He's always out at the footy. The thing is, you're saying it as a hypothetical gay man. Oh, you go geocaching? There's nothing hypothetical about that at all.
We'll get smashed before we go out to the football as well, mate. I'll keep doing what I do. No, you're changing. I can't wait for your arguing points to come back to me with that one.
You know when you're in court and you make a really good point, so you just Fortnite dance on them?
Paul,
that was sick.
Paul permanently he emotes all the time. Poor bastard, man. He just can't help it. Oh, God, Paul!
It's the eyebrow raise.
Paul, when you're being accused of, like, being shady with, like, younger women, this is not the way to do a response video.
You can't just make it sexual.
No, you can't!
You can't try and pull on your response video.
You can't! You can't use a response video as a way to try and put yourself out there to the world. That's the worst thing to do, man. Paul, you're 42, not 14. There's a huge difference.
How old is his child, allegedly?
Well, I think, well, he's 42 now. I think he had, he was 26 and she was like 17, I think. Some people say she was 16. So, you know, you could work that out. I mean, it's legal.
Well, so she's 20, the child. Is that quick maths?
Yeah, his son must be...
Got a son? He must get so bullied.
Oh, mate. Well, yeah, but apparently there's another video, which we'll get to, where he talks about how he can't visit his son this month for Father's Day because he's got too many cameos to do. Sorry, son. I know that I'm your divorced dad, but I can't visit you because I've got a cameo to do. Right, let's see what's next. I love this because it's so believably him. When a parody of you gets like nearly 300,000 likes, doesn't that kind of drive you up the wall? Dan, I worry about you, Dan, because you are so close to looking like him. Yeah, that maybe that's an issue.
Doppelganger.
Yeah.
I tuned into Snapshot I Live, and it was exactly what I expected.
I'm going to be busy for the next month. Really busy. Hannah, thank you for the time. I'll be too busy. So what are you going to get? Because obviously I'm going to prison.
It's a weird thing to say, isn't it? Obviously, guys, I'm going to prison.
His lawyer's watching this like, Paul!
Paul, stop! they haven't put the case through yet.
Hello, James. We had no court case. I just went straight to prison. And I thought I'd announce that I'm going to prison here. So if you see me about, you didn't, because obviously I'm going to prison, or community service, or whichever one it is. So if you do see my TikToks, it would be me, but not me.
Why does he always pause to do like a little dance when he's defending himself from like crazy fucking comments?
A little ad break from his allegations.
Could you imagine if any other YouTuber...
Put him on the same level as yourself here, Alex.
No, not me. I'm not being accused of anything. But could you imagine if any other YouTuber just halfway through their like apology, like, oh, they've been accused of like something horrific, like racism maybe, and then they just start going, green, green grass. Oh, sorry guys, I'm really sorry. I just got caught up in everything. He does that all the time.
Just singing along with the background music of the apology video.
He's a strange bloke.
My one saving grace from that is the crop to the head, because the amount of booty jiggle I imagine he had when he dropped them.
I don't even want to know.
No, just play it again. And just imagine if it was full body, the drop, the way he like hit the floor.
All right, let's do it.
Tell me that you're glad it's just his head now.
How many takes do you reckon he did? How many?
People down below him in the flat below like, shut up!
Yeah, stop, man! It's like he's banging on the floor.
Oh, Paul's slut dropping in the bathroom again.
Dolly. Hello, love. Hello, duck. Hello, babe. Hello, honey. Hello, sweetie. Hello, cupcake. Hello, my little delectable princess.
Delectable princess.
How is one of your pet names for someone going to have like 36 syllables in it? That just doesn't work. It doesn't really flow off the tongue, does it?
The thing is with cameo, right, is you must know if you are something like Paul that people are probably going to like take what you say, take your cameo, and then they're going to take it massively out of context. Because I'd like to give him the benefit of the doubt. And I'm sure the person has uploaded like their proof or whatever. But I'd like to give him the benefit of the doubt that he didn't know that this was for a 15-year-old girl. Because it might not even have been for that.
Also, you don't know what they asked for on the cameo. They could have said like...
Say all of these things.
Can you just say this script? Or he's just reading the script.
But this is the thing about cameo, right? This is why I stopped doing it. I could say anything and then people could turn it around and decide it is not.
I stopped it because people kept saying, oh, can you make a video but have your feet in it?
This is basically a birthday shout out from Holly via me and my words. You are incredible. Never stop being incredible, babe. An incredible Babs. An incredible you. Never stop being so sweet and incredibly fantastic.
This would make me stop being all of those things. It would turn me into an absolute villain.
We're watching this as a third person.
Yeah, this isn't meant for me.
Exactly. If this was aimed at me, I would cry.
I have had somebody buy me a cameo off of Paul, though. once, genuinely.
I said your name in it?
Yeah, I have it on my phone somewhere. I remember just watching it and just being like, this is...
Starstruck.
Very fucking cool, actually. I'm a big fan of Paul, so that was quite sick. Like, all of his cameos that he has, like, all just people taking the mick out of them. There's nobody's buying them because they want one.
He's just gone to his son. Sorry, I won't be there for... Was it his birthday?
I think it was his son had a present from on Father's Day, but he didn't want to go get it because he was doing cameos.
But sorry, son, you can't see me on Father's Day. I'm going to make myself get bullied online. He's chosen getting bullied over it.
That's Paul's life, man. That's what he does.
Never stop smiling and living life. You're cool. You're beautiful.
No, Paul, you can't call people beautiful because... But the thing is, there's no way that somebody wrote that into the cameo. Because he's not saying that the person who's bought it said they were beautiful. He's saying that he thinks they're beautiful. You're putting yourself in muddy territory here, Paul. I'm just trying to help you, mate. I'm trying to help you here.
What I don't like is the pause for thought. He clearly doesn't know who this person is, but the pause for thought makes me think that they've had a history together.
Yeah, they have, which is not possible because they wouldn't have been alive when he was 15.
You're beautiful. How am I going to tell a 42-year-old man to grow up?
Some people need help, I guess.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Please don't say the... Happy 13th! Paul!
Hope you get the unicorn you've been wanting.
Happy birthday, dear Dolly. Happy birthday to you. Babs, sweetie, cupcake. My little woo-woo-woo. My little boo-boo-boo. My little kingdom.
Fuck, that got a bit aggressive.
I know, man. This is getting kind of terrifying, Paul. I don't know what to say. I'm getting kind of scared of you here.
We were trying to back up, you know, it could have been written in the cameo. That last bit, 100, whatever that was.
That was improv for sure, man.
He went off script there. They watched the camera, they watched it back and they've gone, yeah, this is good. What's he doing now? This is...
I want to see what was written on the original cameo. It was, hey, Paul, can you send my cousin a birthday message? They get this.
They're amazing. And never stop. Again, a message from Holly. To me. To you, love. You incredible dog. Hi.
It's supposed to be the start of the video, isn't it?
No, so Paul says hi at the end of everything because he says the ending of a conversation makes him sad.
Oh, just piss off. what do you mean? The end of a conversation makes you sad, so say hi. It's still the end. Hi's then just going to be upsetting because you can't say hello to anyone anymore.
Yeah, because then... But then
he's going to go... Everyone's going, hi, Paul. He's going to go,
oh. Oh, yeah, it's over. Oh, fuck, they don't want to talk to me. Nobody's saying hello to him anyway. He's just he's bothering me.
That's such bullshit.
I will be going down the legal side of things, and we'll see what comes out of that. The police are already aware
of evidence against me. The police have got pictures of me on lampposts all around my local area.
I can imagine Paul calling up the police going, oh...
abuse online.
And they open up the file and then they start looking into it and they're out there and it's almost like it'd be like if a murderer went,
there's loads of people came knocking on my house. People ask me questions. What about the crime that I committed?
We should look into this. We should find the people responsible. Paul has told on himself the greater police of the United Kingdom.
Police are just like, staying on the line.
That's okay. You're like, yeah, Paul, man, all these people, it's kind of crazy what they, it's harassment for sure, Paul. Can we just carry on? Don't move, by the way. Where are you? Geocaching. Okay. We've dispatched police to your area.
For the time when something may change on social media. We will see what happens with that. But thanks to the legal advice that I've had this morning, I will be going down that front.
What? I did not expect that at the end. Jesus. The dog really makes it, man.
Top comment. So true.
He literally talks like a teacher telling a class off. Funny. But I don't know what he does for a job, because the thing is, he used to always say he had a job, but he's always on TikTok Live. And if he's not on TikTok Live, he's out and about. So I don't believe he's been working for ages. But you got to remember, this man, like, all of these videos, he has a kid. Yes. Have you seen the video where somebody, like, meets up with him, like, they told him they were, like, a 19-year-old girl, and they meet up with him, and then they throw Billy Bear Ham in his face?
Paul gets Billy Bear Ham thrown in face. Then Paul sets his panic alarm off.
Why has he got one?
I don't know, I'm sure he probably hands them out to people.
Might need this in a minute. No, allegedly.
If you ever feel like this geocaching isn't going very well, set this off. I'll come find you. I can't believe he's got a panic alarm. That must mean he's so worried that somebody's going to do something.
Or he's been Billy Bear Hammed so many times that he can smell when it's in the media vicinity. He's like, fuck!
Fuck, get the alarm out.
All pretending to wink at someone.
actually just like fuck off at that point. Like realistically, pretending doesn't even need to.
Well, winking at somebody anyway, like in the street, is just fucking weird. Like don't do that to people. Like don't wink at random strangers. It's just somewhere with a singular light.
It's an interrogation room. He's about to go in for questioning.
What do you regret not doing? Continuing with rugby.
Have a fucking day off.
Rugby?
You do not play rugby. Also, you're gay.
About that is every dance move he does, he pauses afterwards to sort of get the crowd's reaction in.
Yeah, to get the reaction of people.
And get ready for shit to go down.
But there's nobody watching.
He put his hands together and gave us like the look of like, you are not ready for this. And yeah, he just goes...
Yeah, and it's like, Paul, no one cares.
When you spot the Nance Paul.
I feel like if I ever saw him in the street, I'd freak out. Like, I'd actually lose my mind. Like, I can't imagine
like,
he's
scared
real.
Scared or happy? Like, what would you do?
I think I would be excited. I generally think I'd be like, wow, this is, I can't believe it.
Well, your friends, he'd come over and go,
we are, mate.
Alex, how
yeah,
you doing?
Yeah, he would.
You good?
Yeah, I'd do this, I'd match his energy, though. And then, I'd just be sat there like, hey, Paul, man, nice to see you. What's up, man? Hi, Babs. Hi, my delectable little princess.
Don't say hi so many times. It'll be coming and going.
Sure, he'll go, oh, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do with this conversation. Jesus, Paul!
Paul,
man.
Do you know the worst bit? This is not the worst bit, actually. Do you know a bit? That wasn't a filter. He'll have actively have had, like, a light there for him to... Once he's grabbed his... How's he... Oh, wait, he must have it standing up, and then he's, like, switched the light on as he's grabbed himself.
God, I don't know.
Production value is there.
Genuinely, he's put effort in. You can't knock it.
But I've been thinking... What do I do? I've got the chance to do this social media stuff full-time.
What? How's your cameo? Is it cameo? I suppose if you're, what, if you do like 5 for 10, that's like 50 quid. So that's like a day's work. If you're getting 5 a day, I guess you probably could get away with it if you're living with your dad and you're 42 and you don't see your kids. Then yeah, man, and you're not paying child support. But of course you could get away with it.
Could be brand deals.
Yeah, man. He actually does do brand deals, by the way. Brands do approach Paul and do...
What?
And
no,
do
he ads. Doesn't.
Yeah, he does. And they're the weirdest things you've ever seen. And any brand who works with Paul, I will never work with you ever. Fucking just run him over. Jesus Christ.
What is it with weirdos on TikTok not dressing their age?
I don't know, man. I don't get it all. I don't understand it.
Mr. UK TikTok official dressed like Tim Westwood. He dresses like he's in like a member of One Direction.
Every day, it's getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster.
I mean, that's not helping his cause out, is it, let's be honest.
Thinking adulting sucks. First issue there, adulting. Just wanting to play with Lego, eat crisp sandwiches, and roll down a hill.
Hashtag relatable.
Gone. Fuck, man. It's so hard being an adult now because I have had to really give up my love for just fucking rolling down hills.
The amount of times that I've had my crisps on my plate here and my sandwich here,
and, you go,
and I've
just,
gone...
I can't. Oh, I just can't anymore.
The only time they meet is in my stomach.
Oh, grow up, George, grow up! No more crisp sandwiches, man! No more! Fucking hell, come on, Alex.
He's literally 42, making himself lunch. He's like, don't look at the walkers. Don't look at the walkers.
Like, I can't do this. Well, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you want us to react to any more Snapchat Eye TikToks, please, we will do so. Please check out George's channel. It's linked in the description below. He's uploading videos. You should definitely go and watch them. And we will see you guys very soon.
Hi.
Amazing.